I don't know if y'all remember who Alicia Keys is right here. She sang one time with Barack Obama. She said, "Barack is going to set the world on fire." I want you to look at her logo real quick. See the A and K? Alicia Keys, see? And so the A and the K show you the key actually, right side up, upside down. So she knows. And let's watch what she said at the Grammy Awards real quick. Watch this. Okay. Here we go. Here we go. Ready?
Who runs the world? I'm taking it in, excuse me. Who runs the world?
Look at Michelle Obama, Michael. Well, that's, I mean, if you believe that's a woman, okay, but anyway, even Barack called this person Michael several times on accident in public. I've done videos on it. So, why is she pointing to the ground? Who runs the world? Look at that. Look at that. Just pointed to the ground. So, I'm just going to freeze frame it. Look right here. Look at the look. And she's, or he, or it is married to the one that's the son of perdition, the Antichrist. And look at that. What is she doing at the Grammy Awards anyway? So let's watch that one more time.
Excuse me. Who runs the world?
Look at that. Okay, now, let's just talk honestly. She's straight up saying the one in the pit, the angel of mama's pit. I mean, there's no way to convolute that. I mean, she just went and look at the look on her face. It says everything. Okay. Let me show you just a couple short little movie clips just to show you how in your face this is. And then I'm going to destroy their entire kingdom and show them that they don't run the world. I guarantee you in this video, I will show you who runs the world. Okay? It's gonna be fun. It's gonna be really fun. So here's a clip from Indiana Jones movie and the Kingdom of the Crystal Skull. I want you to hear what this scientist lady says right here. It's very telling. Turn it all the way up. Turn the volume up.
Skulls at Akator. Whoever finds them will control the greatest natural force the world has ever known. Power over the mind of man.
Okay, so whoever controls them will have the great have control over the greatest resource the world has ever known. Power over the mind of man. Okay, now I'm going to play this little part because, see, they put this in the movies just like I showed you the time machine where he says, "We bred ourselves into Cass, some to be our eyes and ears." Exactly. Why do you think there's signs in people's yards that say, it's like neighborhood watch signs that show sheep with their heads getting cut off? Because they know that from below ground there's a scorpion race and they bred, and all around us we are surrounded by that race. Christians are few and far between. True Christians, we're very rare. There's not a lot of us. So here, that know the truth. Now watch. I'm gonna play what she says right here. Just listen to what she says right here. Let's see.
From the inside.
Here we go, right here.
Of history, your soldiers attack on our command. We will be everywhere at once, more powerful than a whisper, invading your dreams. Thinking your thoughts for you while you sleep. We will change you, Dr. Jones. All of you, from the inside. We will turn you into us. And the best part? You won't even know it's happening.
Okay, so we'll change you into us. And the best part of all, you won't even know it's happening. Okay? So, just for kicks and grins, watch this. I'll just do this just for kicks and grins. Watch. I'll just show you how obvious this is. I can type in I can type in Jungle Book. Let's see. Ka. Hypnosis, I think, tries to eat Mowgli. There we go. Let's see. There we go. Ka tries to eat Mowgli. Let's see. Here we go. Hang on 1 second. Let me just turn this down. Let me just pause this for 1 second. Okay, so Ka is going to be, Jungle Book's going to be no different than what you just saw. Just watch and listen.
I'm not like those so-called fair-weather friends of yours. You can believe in me. Trust in me. Just in me. Shut your eyes. Trust in me. Hold still, please. You can sleep safe and sound, knowing I am around. Slip into silent slumber, sail on a silver mist, slowly and surely your senses will cease to resist.
Okay, so slowly and surely your senses will cease to resist. Now, look, I want you to show some. Right when Ka turns Mowgli upside down, this is the head of a snake eating Mowgli. Mowgli's closed eye becomes the eye of a snake. This is the nose of a snake. This is the bottom jaw of a snake. And Mowgli's hair is coming out of the mouth of a snur. This is a snake. Just depends on how you look at it. That's the eye. There's the open mouth. There's the bottom jaw. And so, but see the way they do it. Now, if you just look at it, that is an open mouth. So it just depends on how you see it. But did you see how he turned him upside down? Slowly and surely, your senses will cease to resist. So there it is. Same thing, no different, exactly the same. Okay, now let me show you this. Lady Gaga.
The performance we did last night at the Grammys was, and what we've been doing with the egg and their rebirth,
Yeah.
it's meant to signify an artistic statement of birthing a new race, a race within the race of humanity.
Birthing a new race, a race within the race of humanity.
Birthing a new race, a race within the race of humanity.
Okay. Birthing a new race, a race within the race of humanity. Let's hear Alicia Keys one more time. Now, don't forget what Alicia Keys' symbol is. Let's see.
Excuse me. Who runs the world?
I mean, you can't even.
Who runs the world?
So, is there any question that they're all sold out to Satan? I mean, how could anyone, as above, so below? They're talking about as above on the planet's surface, as so below, because the race of scorpions is running things from the pit. Now, I'm going to show you all this. Now, I'm going to show you who really runs the world for all you shills and for all you that have sold out. Okay. Let's talk about who runs the world. Okay. Let me show you who really runs the world. Okay, here we go. Oops, hang on 1 sec. Okay, so now for a reference point, remember if they worship Satan, who is it that they really worship? And you might be going, well, what do you mean by that exactly? Let me show you what I mean by that. So if you worship Satan, Michael Obama or Michelle, whatever you want to call that person, I don't believe it's a woman. I believe he has a penis because I've seen him walk downstairs and if a girl's vagina bounces like that, then I've never seen one that looks like that, so whatever. Anyway, so here we are in Revelation 9. We note that there's locusts that are coming out of the pit, but the thing about the locusts that's most, that has any real impact, I mean, do you really care if a bunch of locusts come out and it says locusts because of the way they move? Or do you care if they're coming out of the pit because they have tails like scorpions? Pick one. I would care because they have tails like scorpions, because if something's coming out of a pit that's been there since the beginning of this world and it's coming out, what's one thing if it's coming out and it's a locust, but it's a whole different story if it's like got a tail like a scorpion and it stings us, because that would, you know, suggest that it's going to be pretty horrifying, right? So the thing that makes them really like dangerous is the fact that they have tails like unto scorpions. Otherwise, you know, you'd have to reassess what is it that they do. Well, the Bible tells us what they do. They come out of the pit. They have the power to torment men, and they have tails as scorpions, and their power was in their sting. They will sting men. Men will seek death and will not find it. They will desire to die, but death will flee from them. Well, that sounds like you're incapacitated, because when you get stung, you're probably incapacitated. It's probably a gestation and you're becoming something else. So that's what I would suggest. So here we go. So see, they have, it was given to them that they should not kill them, but they should be tormented 5 months. And their torment was the torment of a scorpion. The word here is Scorpios. And it means to pierce from its sting. And it's through the idea of concealment also as a watch, a sentry, or a scout. Now, don't forget, remember the bill that just got passed for abortion means to sting, to pierce like a scorpion. That's pretty perfect, isn't it? But let's look who their boss is. So all these scorpions that are coming out of the pit, they had tails like unto scorpions, and there were stings in their tails, and the power was to hurt men. Okay, and they had a king over them. So who had a king over them? The scorpions from the pit. You can call them scorpions, you can call them locusts, but here it's scorpions. See, right here, scorpions, I'll change the color. They had tails like unto scorpions, and there were stings in their tails. And the word stings is to prick, sting, figuratively poison, divine impulse. So they're going to come out, and the threat is the fact that they have tails like scorpions. So they had a king over them. See the king right here? There's their king over them, which is the angel of the bottomless pit. And we're going to look at this name right here. Apollyon in Greek. So let's look at the name Apollyon. Apollyon, that is destroyer. And I'm just going to change that color to Satan. So Satan is Apollyon. There's no arguing that, because it says it right here. His name is in Greek is Apollyon, but that means Satan. So Apollyon is Satan. So they just said, you know, Michael Obama, who rules the world? And he points, who rules the world? And they're all glorifying their king because that's who they serve. This is a no-brainer. Let me show them how wrong they are. You want to see how wrong they are? Let me show you how wrong they are. Okay? Y'all want to see something amazing? You want to see just amazing? I want to give all the glory to God right now. Father, Abba, thank you. By the way, anyone that tries to change that, I said Abba. That's what we're supposed to call our Father in heaven. We cry out Abba, A-B-B-A, Abba Father. Abba, I know we're supposed to love our enemies, and I know you know my heart. I love them, but you know what? I just don't tolerate their nonsense. God have mercy on them. But it's time to finish them off in the ring, because this is a contest. So let's finish it. All right, amen. All right, so here we go. Let me show you a really nifty little thing I made for you guys. And it's in the show notes. And I want to show you this. This is just Such a great thing. So I'm going to open this picture, but while that picture is populating, I'm going to go to eSword, and I'm going to go to Matthew. And y'all might want to follow me. Matthew, we're going to go to chapter 27. And I want to show you, I showed you the other day, because this is, you know, I just gave you just a little dose, but I'm going to slam it home now. It's time to round the corner of the track and give it everything you got towards that finish line, because the finish line's right in sight now. And I know this because the Lord's proven out the Bible now, and he's shown me repetitively, you have accomplished that which I purposed you for, to understand the Word of God and to show the identity of Christ to this generation, because it's been hidden from you. Let me show you. Here you go. Watch this. This is amazing. So from the sixth hour, there was darkness over all the land until the ninth hour. Do y'all remember the Heineken commercial where the guy goes in the party and it's a six, and he goes in and parties, and then they throw him out, turns it upside down, it's a nine, and behind him is an 11 on the door? I'll show you that commercial in a sec, but watch this. So there was darkness from the sixth hour to the ninth hour until the ninth hour, so six and nine, it's a reversal. And about the ninth hour, when ninth means judgment, Jesus cried with a loud voice, saying, Eli, Eli, lama sabachthani, that is to say, my God, see, look, my God, Eli, my God, see, twice. I'm going to do that in just green again. There we go. My God, my God. There it is. My God, why hast thou forsaken me? Eli, Eli, lama sabachthani. That's what it means. So let's click on the word. I'm going to change that one to yellow, just so it's easier to see. There we go. There you go. So Eli, Eli, the word number is 2241. So I'm going to click on 2241 and see, it says, my God. That's what Eli means. So see the E-L and then I? It means my God. That's why there's an I there. But look at, here's what, and it, oh, by the way, I want to make sure I pronounce this right, because I got a super duper surprise for you guys. Y'all are going to freak out. Watch this. This is awesome. This is amazing. This is one way the Lord let me know we've come to the end. Watch this. So when you look at the word, it looks like Eli, Eli, right? Like, but look how it's pronounced. Ali. Look, Ali. Ali. Now I noticed this the day the Lord showed it to me. He already conveyed this to me. I saw someone mention it in one of the comments, but this is fascinating, because that's going to come up here in just a minute. It Ali, see, but it's, here's what it is. It's Hebrew word 410. It's L right there. L, see, Hebrew word 410. Nobody on planet Earth can argue with this. Nobody. You can argue with it. It says Eli, Eli, my God, my God. Well, what's the word for God right here? It's Hebrew word 410, El. So it's Ali, Ali, lama sabachthani, my God, my El, why hast thou forsaken me? See, El right there. I'll do it again right in front of you. Okay, so right there, my God. See, my God, Eli, 2241. My God, what's the word for God? Hebrew word, 410. Let's go check it out. El. Mighty, and especially the Almighty. There it is. So El is the Almighty God. Now, there's this group called Elohim. Elohim's in deep, 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 eternal torture, punishment, trouble. And they're going to try and play it out to the end. So when Jesus cried out, he said, El, El, because Eli, Eli, Ali, Ali, it means my El, my El, my God, my God. Why have you forsaken me? even says it. My God, why hast thou forsaken me? I and my Father are one. So what Jesus said in John 10, verse 30, I and my Father are one. Well, who's Jesus? He's Emmanuel. We're told in scriptures, we're supposed to call him, you will call him Emmanuel. Watch. Isaiah chapter 7, verse 14, I believe. Yeah. See, there shall be a virgin that shall conceive and bear a son. You shall call his name Emmanuel, right there. So what does Emmanuel mean? It means with us is. That's what Emmanuel means. Emmanuel with us is El. Okay, so, and who's El? El is God. With us is God. Hebrew word 4:10. See, so nobody on the planet can argue with this. Nobody, unless you're delusional or unless you want to try and just argue just to try and confuse people. But that would only make you delusional or it would make you an opponent like the one that I have in the corner of the ring right now who's getting pummeled because here comes your knockout punch. Yeah, found your weakness. Totally found it. You shouldn't have exposed yourself. When you have a weakness, you don't sit there and expose yourself. You try and deflect, but you didn't do that. So let's just take you down now, okay? Okay, here we go. Let's take them down. Now, I'm going to show you these names in every part of the Bible. That way, no one can argue with the truth of what you're seeing. El. It means the Almighty God. That's what El means. We just showed it to you, and I'm going to show it to you again and again and again. But Elohim means of the Supreme God, of El. See, Elohim is not El. And we've proven that using Ezekiel 28 repetitively. And I'm going to do it again. Because the enemy's in the corner of the ring just getting pummeled down to the ground because they expose their weakness. Here you go. Let's do it. Daniel. Daniel. What does Daniel mean? Daniel means it's Daniel. It means judge of El. Mikael. Who is like El? Oh, wait a minute. I clicked on the wrong one. I got a better one. I made sure that we made it super perfect for everybody. Ready? Here we go. Alicia. Lady Gaga. Michael or Michelle as the case may be. I got a little something to show you guys. Everyone who follows Apollyon and thinks he's God, I got bad news for you. It's right here. Freak out. Y'all can freak out now because now it's proven and no one can stop it. No one can stop this. I stand against you. Here it is. Daniel. It's Daniel, judge of El. That's why it ends in E-L. Michael. It means who is like El. El is God, Hebrew word 4:10. Michael, who is like El, which is God, Hebrew word 4:10. Joel, you know, like the book of Joel, it's Joel. It means Jehovah is his El, God, Hebrew word 4:10. The book of Samuel, Samuel. It means heard of El, God, Hebrew word 4:10. Emmanuel, it means with us is El, God, Hebrew word 4:10. Don't you think it's obvious that the Supreme God named his prophets with words that reflect his character and who he is? Yeah, it's like, Scotto! In the corner, it took it overhand. Haystacker. Oh, it's got to hurt. It's got to hurt, right? Well, anyway, the point is, the continued nonsense just invigorates me. Picked the wrong guy to do that to. So here you go. Let me serve you a little bit of your own stuff here. For those that like to point to the ground when they say, who rules the world? And I'm going to show you who everybody is in just a minute. And we're, by the way, you know what, guys? Let me just say this. Right now, I'm just kind of laying out all the facts. We're going to get into the really fun stuff here in a minute. It's like, yeah, y'all are going to freak out. But I got something so cool to share with you. I got something that's so cool. Okay, stay here. Over here. I mean, if this isn't the coolest thing right now in the world, I got even more. Here it comes. Okay, Daniel, judge of El, judge of God. Mikael, who is like God, El. Yoel, Jehovah is God, El. Samuel, heard of God, El. Emmanuel, with us is God. That's Jesus. Okay, now, let's prove it book by book really quick. So, we'll start with Daniel. Okay, so if we go down to, let's see. If we go, let's see, right here, we go to Daniel. We'll go to chapter 12. At the time of the end, shall Michael stand up? That's who I met in an alley. A lot of people didn't believe me. He was calling me to service. Here it is. Micah. There it is. Micah El. And see, it's Hebrew word for 10. It means who is like. And then I put El in green. God. Because that is Hebrew word for 10. So Hebrew word for 10. It means the Almighty. So who is like El? That's what. Mikael means Micah El, who is like God. Now let's go down to the name Daniel. It's the book of Daniel. Oh, by the way, I don't know if you noticed this, but those were, I think, five alleged women standing on the stage pointing to who the boss is. No, the boss is the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. His name is El, and he came in the flesh, and that's Emmanuel. Yeah, Yeshua, Christ, Jesus. So let me show you something. So there shall be a time of trouble. But in the end, Mikael, who is like God, shall stand up, the great prince which standeth for the children of thy people. There shall be a time of trouble. Look at the word trouble. A female rival. Haven't you noticed all the shirts? The future is female. See, female rival. Affliction. Tribulation. So the great tribulation is the female rival, the queen of heaven, that's taking over the surface because she got a bunch of angels trapped in host bodies to breed with the above ground race. And they sent all that energy down to the pit to a group of scorpions. And they're replacing everybody with another scorpion race above ground that are the eyes and the ears of the race below. And I can prove it all day long. I can prove this all day long now. When I say I, the Lord's allowed me to. He gave it to me. It's a gift. And I'm giving you the gift. It's awesome. So, at the time of the end, who is like God? Mikael shall stand up, the great prince which standeth for the children of thy people. There shall be a time of trouble, female rival. That's why you see these shirts that say the future is female. Exactly. Ever since there was a nation, oh my gosh, a foreign nation, a flight of locusts. Creepy. See, flight of locusts. There you go. Even until that time, and at that time, thy people shall be delivered, everyone who is found written in the book. But let's look at the name Daniel. See, but thou, Daniel, shut up the words and seal the book until the time of the end. Okay, I'm just going to be very blunt. That's why I was called. The Lord gave me the unrolled scroll. The book has been unsealed, and here's how it got unsealed. It's how you unroll a scroll in the old days. Right side up, upside down. Just like Alicia Keys' little name. You know, the A and the K? Yeah, but. So here we go. But thou, O Daniel. Look at the word, Daniel. Okay, so here it is. I'm not lying. There it is. 1840. See it right there? Word number 1840. 1840. I'll just color it green just to make sure you see it. There it is. 1840. Click on 1840. It means, it's from the root 410, which is L. But it means judge of El, judge of God. El, see, El is the name of God. And it's from Hebrew word 4:10. So Daniel means judge of El, which is God. El. Michael means who is like God. And I want to highlight these now, because when I go back to them, I like to see them nice and crisp and clean. Okay, there you go. For who is like El, Mikael, the name of an archangel. Okay, let's see. Who do we have next? So we did Daniel, judge of El. We did Mikael, who is like El. Let's do Joel. Okay, next one. Let's knock him out of the park. You think you run the world? You're nuts. God and his prophets have been showing you who does, but y'all are so arrogant. I know you think you do. The word of the Lord. Look at that, Lord. Lord, Hebrew word 3068, the self-existent, eternal Jehovah. By the way, some people don't know this, but Jehovah, when you walk back Jehovah, you'll find out it is also Yah. And here we go. See, Yah, you know, there you go, right there, Yah. Okay, so, and it's like the Lord most vehement, and it's like a name they're not supposed to really utter, the sacred name Yah. So, now we know that for sure, the word of the Lord, self-existent, eternal Jehovah, came to the prophet Joel, right here, look. Look how it's pronounced. It's pronounced Yo-El. Let me get that. Not my best highlight job. See, Yoel. See the L there? Again, it's always the same. Hebrew word 4:10. There it is. Which is the Almighty God. And it means Jehovah is his God, which is El. See, we're not fooled anymore. Y'all are caught. Y'all have been lying to everybody, but eventually lies get found out. I know I used to lie a lot before I got saved. It was like natural. It was like normal. So anyway, so this is their group though, because see, the locust, the Palmer worm and all that stuff. You remember I showed you the abortion bill. Kill babies was the abortion bill number, whatever it was, 2491, whatever it was. I believe it was 2491. It literally means to pierce, kill, and destroy, like a scorpion stinger. Well, isn't that convenient? Because there's a scorpion race. They want to kill all the baby lambs. They want to get eyes on them. It's a lamb, kill it. There's no room for lambs in their new society. No. And so, see, but they want to save the cankerworm, see? So that which the Palmer worm has left, the locust has eaten. It's a locust because of its rapid increase, which is above ground. They increase. Look at planet Earth. When I was a kid, I'm telling you, I could drive from here to Dallas and there was hardly anything in between, you know. Now you drive from San Antonio to Dallas, it's built up most of the way. It's crazy. Just explosion. Population. Okay, so see, the locust, that which the Palmer worm has left, the locust has eaten, and that which the locust has left hath the canker worm eaten, to lick up a devourer, specifically a young locust. And that's what the other bill was that Miss Trans introduced in Virginia to save the canker worm, 2495. And if you look up the number 2495 in the Bible, guess what it is? Egg. You know, like an insect egg. Kill the lambs, save the worms. Of course. But you know who rules their show? The angel of the bottomless pit, which is Apollyon, which is Satan. See? It's all perfect. Okay, so now let's go back and let's knock these out. Who else? So Joel, it means Jehovah is his God. I did show that to you, right? Joel, right here, 3100. It says Jehovah is his El, God, because God is El, the Almighty. Let's do another one. Okay, let's Samuel. It means heard of God, because if you know the story of Samuel, when he was in his bed, he heard his name being called, and he went to investigate. And let's see, one, two, let's see. Hang on one sec. Give me one sec. Okay, now, so check this out. In 1 Samuel 3, 1, here's the name Samuel. See it right here? Look, Samuel 8:50. So let's click on it. It's Shemuel. So the way you actually pronounce it is Shemuel, because it's Samuel, Shemuel. And it means heard of God right there. And it's, again, Hebrew word 4:10. Do you think it's strange that these angels of the Lord God, these prophets of the Lord God, and the Lord God himself in the flesh has the name El? It's not arguable anymore, is it? So Genesis 1, they didn't want anyone to find out. This was the key of keeping all the angels like myself in the dark. They don't want you to find out your identity. They've hidden you in this world, and you're in such total darkness. The last thing they want you to find out is your identity. But Jesus said, do not your own scriptures say you are Elohim. Elohim means of the Supreme God, which is Elyon. See, I'm not lying to you. Jesus said it. I'm going to repeat it, and I'm going to show it to you. John chapter 10. And this is, by the way, this is all about sheep. Look, Jesus is talking all about his sheep. I am the good shepherd. Look, look how many times he uses sheep here. Okay. I am the shepherd of the sheep. Yeah, the porter openeth, and the sheep hear his voice. He calls his own sheep by name. Let me ask you this question. What's the picture that the enemy's drawn of me? A dead sheep on me, because they're hunting me. I'm an angel, and they hunt us. They hunt all of you that are angels. You're trapped in host bodies, but you're lost in their world. That's why Jesus said, I've come to seek and find the lost sheep of the house of Israel. Seek that which is lost. Did you know Jesus said your identity is hidden in Christ? That our identity, who we are, our identity is hidden in Christ. But guess what? We're hidden in their system. We're hidden over the time span from the beginning to the end of the world. There will be a sheep that lived during this century. There will be a sheep that lived during this century in this country, in this family. We're all over the place. We're all over the time zones. We're everywhere. And he comes and finds us in whatever time zone that we're at, wherever we are. He comes and rescues us. You want to see something incredible? Yeah? You want to see something awesome? Y'all remember what the name is? Y'all remember what the name is for Jesus when it says, the name for God when he says, Ali, Ali, Lama Sabachthani? It's El, right? Well, let me finish this John thing real quick, and I got a surprise for you. See, we're all his sheep. I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd gives his life for the sheep. You know, the hireling leaves the sheep, so we're the sheep. We're the sheep. I know my sheep, and my sheep know me. Sheep, sheep. Look at all the sheep. Okay. And then it says, I and my Father are one. One. El. El, the Almighty. And then with us is El, Emmanuel. That's why Jesus is with us is the Almighty. But they hate him. They hate him, and they hate his children. They hate his followers. Who hates him? Elohim. They hate him. They hate him. Now, watch. So, see, as soon as he said, I and my father are one, they're going to take up stones to stone him. Then the Jews took up stones to stone him. And Jesus said, hey, many good works have I shown you from the Father. For which works do you stone me? And they said, we don't stone thee for good work, but for blasphemy, because you, being a man, maketh thyself God. They got it backwards. And Jesus said unto them, is it not written in your law? I said, ye are gods? He said, he even said it. See the word I right there? He said, I said, ye are gods. And then he said, by the way, and the scriptures cannot be broken. Just so you can't try and weasel out of your eternal punishment that's coming. Because you committed treason and you weren't willing to admit you did it. You kept trying to cover it up and kill his children. So, you know, you had your opportunity. You either take the opportunity or you deal with the reality that Jesus is El in the flesh. So, and he's here saying, oh, no, 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 no. I'm the Son of God. Y'all are gods. Which just convicted everybody, didn't it? Oh, Genesis 1, what does it say? And Elohim said, let us make man in our idol, vain show, idol. Elohim is an idol. Does God like idols? No, he doesn't. So, Psalm 82, and then we're going to go to the most awesome surprise I could give you in the world. Psalm 82, told you. I have said, see the word I? It means I, just like Jesus said it. I have said, ye are gods, right there. Ye are gods, and all of you are children of, okay, well, let's look at the word gods. It means, the word is Elohim, it means gods. Look at the little word right there, of. I'm going to make that a super crazy color so it's not mistakable. Really bright pink. Of the supreme God. So, gods, Elohim, are of the supreme God. Well, look right here. It says, you are gods and all of you are children of the supreme God. See, it says it right there. Elyon. It even says it. All of you. So, you're all Elohim. Get over it. And all of you are children of Elyon, see right there, the Most High. Yeah, so the Supreme Most High God. There's no arguing with this. But Jesus came to seek and find that which was lost. I was so lost in this world. Nothing made any sense to me anymore. I was like, man, I made the money. You know, I made $1 million in 1 year. You know, I had the cars, everything, girls, everything. I was a pro skydiver. I could do whatever I wanted. I could drive to the airport and throw my junk out on the curb and tell a guy, hey, just hold on to that. I'll be back in a minute and jump on a plane and go wherever I wanted. I thought that was freedom. Everybody thinks that's freedom. You know, if you have a lot of cash, you can go do whatever you want whenever you want. That's not freedom. It's slavery. Because what you did to get all that, and you compromised yourself, and you start thinking that's freedom, you know, freedom to fornicate, yeah, I'm tired of that girl, let's go to this girl, you know, just do whatever you want, nobody tells me what to do, I do whatever I want. Everybody thinks that's freedom. Wrong. Wrong. I thought it was, but I was wrong. Guilty. So, let me show you something really cool. So, we're all lost in their system. And we think we have this freedom because if we have a money or position or stuff like that, we think we're all doing great. Let me show you Matthew 27 one more time now. Ready? Matthew 27. Everybody say it with me. What did Jesus say? He cried out in a loud voice. And it looks like it's Eli, Eli, but let's. What does it say? It says, Ali, Ali. So he says, Ali, Ali, lama sabachthani. And right then and there, he was separated from the Lord God. He was God in the flesh, and he was separated for your well-being so you could come home with no penalty. So you could come in. You could say, no, you can come back. There is no penalty. I just paid it. I was willing to separate myself and come into the system, die on a cross for all your sins. And then he said, it is finished. Ali, Ali. Ali, Ali, income free. Ali, Ali, oxen free. Have y'all ever heard that? As soon as I read this the other day, I knew it. I was like, Jesus came to seek that which was hid. Let me show you. You know, like a giant game of hide and seek over thousands of years. Colossians. For if ye be risen with Christ, seek those things which are above, which Christ sitteth on the right hand of God. Set your affection on things above, not on things on the earth. For you are dead, and your life is hid with Christ in God. So, see, our life is truly hidden with Christ in God. But we're in this system, so we're hidden, and Jesus has come to seek and find. Oh, you mean like hide and seek? Yeah. For the Son of Man has come to seek and to save that which was lost. Hide and seek through all these years. And when he went to the cross, he did it all for you. Ali, Ali, income free. Or Ali, Ali, oxen free, because just like oxen, we are tethered together. We are yoked together, an angel and a demon that were yoked together. You know, like that right there. Like a W. See the U right there? A U and a U. That's a yoke. And did you know that in the game hide and seek and other games even, when you hear the words Ali Ali oxen free or Ali Ali income free, it means that the game is entirely over. Look right here. It means the game is entirely over. And it says in the Dictionary of Regional English that the phrase may be derived from all ye outs and free, all the outs and free, or possibly calling all the outs and free. In other words, all you are out may come in without a penalty. And there's variants of it, and I went and looked at them. I used to hear Ali Ali income free right here, but Ali Ali oxen free is very common. Ali Ali income free. And did you know Jesus cried out, Ali Ali lama sabachthani, so we could all come in free. Even the game hide and seek bears witness to the truth. Yeah, they've been mocking the crap out of us since we were little kids playing hide and seek, and they're making fun of us. Ali Ali income free. They know it's Ali Ali. They know that Jesus cried out Ali Ali, and they're mocking all the Christians, the scorpion race that's everywhere. Let me show you something. Let me show you how busted they are. This is so cool. Let me show you how the Lord let me bust them. Let me just, this is so great. I mean, this is this. And you know what? What I'm going to do is I'm going to do a video right on the heels of this where I show you all the data now, just all the data. And I've given you the scriptures, but I'm going to show you all this data with the scorpions and the two races. I really want to show you all the data in just one video. But let me show you this real quick. Watch this. So I showed you that the National Neighborhood Watch sign is this thing right here. You see it? That's a sheep getting its head cut off. Here's an actual sheep. I turned it upside down right there. Look. See it? So they have a sheep getting its head cut off as a neighborhood watch sign. Now think about this. Just wrap your brain around this. See, it's their world. They're everywhere. The scorpion race is just like the whole the whole surface. And then we pop up, we get born again within this whole surface of all these people in humanity. And when we get born again, they're all over us. I was wondering the night I got saved. Well, no, way before the night I got saved. I was just being zeroed in on. I'm like, what the hell is going on? I thought maybe some of the people I used to deal with in my past had this like wouldn't give up the vendetta. I'm like, guys, y'all already tried to kill me how many times and missed? Can't you just let it go? I was like, what the hell, man? These guys just don't stop. And so, you know, I was wondering when I got saved, I was like, who are these people that are zeroing in on me? And I couldn't figure it out. It's the above ground race. They saw me waking up. And a lot of people call it gang stalking. It's not gang stalking. You're in their world, and all the sentries and all the sentries and scouts, they keep an eye on you. And if they see you coming to the truth, they're all over you. And the number one job is don't let them find out who they really are. We're angels. Jesus said, do not your own scriptures say ye are Elohim? Elohim are angels. So if you found out you were an angel and you knew you're actually an angel, you wouldn't be all so scared of them, would you? Because if you're an angel, that means El is your dad. And they don't want you to know that. They're like, don't let them find that out. That's the number one thing. Go watch the movie Glass. I went and watched it yesterday. I was like, oh my gosh. So watch. Watch this. So they have these neighborhood watch signs. It's a sheep getting its head cut off, like keep an eye on all the sheep. And in the end of the world, that they're going to implement that. Let me show you this one right here. It says, this area protected by neighborhood watch. Now, you see that sign? Let me ask you a question. What do you think that really is? What do you think that is? Do you think that's a guy crawling into a house? No. I know that would be normal to think that because it says, this area protected by neighborhood watch. But that's not what it is. Okay, now remember, what did Jesus refer to us as? Sheep. See, here's the largest altar in the world. Killing sheep. Why do you think the largest altar in the world is a dead sheep that's got a penis and a vagina? Well, that's what it says in Genesis 1:26 and in Genesis 1 verse 2. And the spirit of angels, Elohim, moved over the semen. And that's exactly what you're looking at. You're looking at a penis, a vagina, and angels melting into semen. So Genesis 1, I was given a gift that proves Genesis 1 verse 2 is true. That's all. Yeah. Spirit of Elohim moving over the semen. But they know it and you don't. And they don't want you to know it. That's why they hate Johnny. So there's the spirit of Elohim moving over the semen. And there they are worshiping the dead sheep. But because Jesus has come to seek those which were lost, and our identity is hidden, hide and seek. And I'm sorry, but this is so amazing. Did you know that Isaiah 43? He knew. He told us in Isaiah 43. He knew we were going into the system. And he's like, don't worry. When you go over, I'll be with you. And I'll be with you when you cross over to the other side. Look, thus saith the Lord, the self-existent Jehovah, who created thee, O heel catcher, supplanter, that's Jacob, and formed thee, O Israel. He knows he's going to call us. He knows he's going to redeem us. Look, it means he will rule as God, but look at the root of the word. He knows it. It means to prevail, to have power as a prince. He's like, don't worry. All of Israel, every one of us that knows who we are, we know we're angels, princes. So it's like, don't worry when you go into the system, fear not. Thus saith the Lord that created thee, O Jacob, that formed thee, O Israel. He will rule as God, and it means to have power as a prince. There it is, to prevail as a prince. Fear not, for I have redeemed you. Look, to buy back a relative's property. I have redeemed you. I have called you by your name. Okay, thou art mine. Well, he called me by my name, and look, the word name means conspicuous position. Well, Yahweh has given a bell ringer, and I gather the church. Well, that's weird. That's what my name means. I've called you by your name. Look, when thou passest through the waters, I will be with thee. Look, when thou passest through, look, it means to cross over, alienate, to cover in copulation. Look, you see the word copulation right there? Do y'all know what copulation means? So when thou passest through the waters, the semen. So when you cross over to the other side into this dimension, crossing over through the waters, through the semen, don't worry, I'm going to be with you. And then we're going to play a giant game of hide and seek for thousands of years. It's like, oh my God, this is mind-boggling. Yeah, ollie ollie, oxen free. Now, why would he say oxen free, or why would they make the game oxen free, or why is it ollie ollie income free? Well, if you're out there, you get to come in back to the kingdom of heaven free because you didn't have to pay for your charges against you. He paid them, so ollie ollie, you know, ll L means to prevail as a prince. Income free, you get to come in free. Or let's say oxen free. Watch this. This is great. Okay, so now let's go to 1 Kings 12. 1 Kings 12. Okay, ready? So, and now whereas my father did laid, look, did load, impose a heavy burden. Whereas my father did laid with you a heavy yoke. You know what a yoke is? It's a yoke as imposed on the necks. I showed you one just a minute ago, and I'll show it to you again. I will add to your yoke, but I will I will add to your yoke. My father chastised you with whips, but I will chastise you with scorpions. Look at that, a scorpion. And look at that, oh my gosh, the word is akrab. You know where I've seen that before. Oh my gosh, you know where the word akrab is? I remember, I did a video on it. Ready, here we go. Where's the word akrab from, Johnny? Let me show you. So great. So fun, man. Okay, let's see. Where's that old word, akrab? Let's see. Here we go. Okay, now watch. Because you, Stanley Ann Dunham's passport renewal, Barack Hussein Obama Sobarka. Backwards, it's akrab, eos. Well, eos is goddess of the dawn. The word eos means goddess of the dawn. And akrab means scorpion. There you go. You know, Barack Sobarka, a scorpion, goddess of the dawn. Sorry, I got it. You know, guys, I'm sorry, I'm laughing. It's like, what else are you gonna do? Look at the perfection in this. This, oh, I thought who rules the world? Anyone from Italy? You know what that means, right? Yeah. Who rules the world? You think you rule the world, you're wrong. Okay, so I did impose upon you a heavy burden, a yoke, and I will add to your yoke and chastise you with scorpions. Oh my gosh, let's go to see what a yoke looks like. There's a yoke that you put on oxen. It makes a double U, you know, like an angel yoked to a demon. There you go. And then see, a V and a V makes a double U, just like a yoke does. Oh, that's kind of weird. Now, let's look at the guy that's in the neighborhood, protected by neighborhood watch. Is that a guy's face or is that a scorpion stinger? As he's trying to get out, they're making, they're like, look, it's a, I just put it a little wider. It's, I didn't do any major augmenting or anything. I just colored it in white and put black on the edges, a little darker. That's a scorpion stinger. His whole face is a scorpion stinger. I wrote, white scorpion stinger, no one escapes. See, this, so they're saying nobody escapes. You're in their world. Who runs? They're like, who runs the world? Now, let me show you how that plays out again in the bill from New York to kill all the baby lambs, because they want to kill all the lambs. They want to kill it. If you're born and you're a lamb, kill it. And here is the 2491 abortion bill, and their judgment has come. There you go. You see it right there? Look at the advertisement that was there with this bill. This was on the page. See, it says braid. See, the letter I is a spike. This is the face of a dragon. But look what it says. Everyone plays, nobody leaves. Braid. Oh my gosh. Do you know where the word braid comes from? Daniel 2:43. Isn't this wild? Everything I'm talking about, every single thing I'm talking about, goes straight to the Bible. See, Satan knows the Bible better than most people, but the Lord made me kind of like a theologian. So here we go. Let me show you where the word braid comes from. Let's see. Okay, hang on one sec. Okay, you know what? I'll just go directly to the scripture. Let's go to Daniel. I know my scriptures very well, folks. Daniel 2, verse 43. Here we go. Let's do it. Let's destroy the guy in the corner. Shouldn't have exposed your weakness, by the way. And whereas thou sawest the iron mixed with the miry clay, they shall mingle themselves. Let's look at that word. To commingle, mingle self with. And the word is Arab. See, the word is Arab, A-R-A-B. Now you know why the Arabs that are being forced into all these European countries are 900% rape increase, because they're planting their seeds. It's a different seed from the pit, and they're raping women to spread their seed. That's sick. And guess what? The politicians that allowed it are behind it. Absolutely. Because they're being run by the scorpion guy from the pit. Satan. So there it is, to commingle. And to commingle, read it for yourself. What does that mean? It means to braid. Oh, wow. Look at that. To intermix, to mingle self. And the word just happens to be Arab. Oh, wow. That's not good. Okay, now let's slam it home. Let me show you something really creepy. You know, look at this girl with her cool, you know, haute couture hairdo. It's a scorpion stinger. No one would have ever thought it. Look at this. It's a scorpion stinger. Oh, wow. Look at this. This is a... I'm sorry. Scorpion stingers. Why would you do your hair like scorpion stingers? I'll tell you why. You want to know what the bait was for God's angels? I drew some wings on this guy, and he thinks he's having sex with this hot babe, but this is reality right here. And there's the sting of death. Oh, death, where's thy sting? And here's a really great picture that just really sums it up. That's so great. I have three sides to me. The quiet, sweet side, the fun and crazy side, and the side you never want to see. Boy, that's true, man. And you ever wonder why hell hath no fury as a woman scorned? At this point, I feel sorry for the guy on the mat. God have mercy on him. But hey, you're trying to kill all my brothers and sisters, all my fellow, calling all angels, go watch the movie Glass. If you haven't seen the movie Glass, you know, I did not watch Split. I turned it on, but it was a little too just, ugh. Yeah, I didn't want to watch it. But there's a movie called Unbreakable that you can rent, and you can watch it before you go watch the movie Glass. Go watch the movie Glass. At the end of the movie, look at what's in the train station. It's a big statue of what they didn't want you to know you really are. I'm the angel of the Church of Philadelphia. I know who I am. Praise God. Lord proved it to me. All glory to God. Yes. Yes. So what y'all think? It's like, Cleck, quit laughing so much. I can't help it. It's like, yeah. Listen, for everything y'all see on this screen, I've been through it like so many times. It's ridiculous. So when the Lord shows me something, he just makes sure it's just pounded into me. And by this time, you know, I'm a little bit daffy. It's like, dude, you know, I've had to deal with it on so many different levels. It's just mind-boggling. All glory to God. I have come that you may have peace and joy, and you may have life and have it more abundantly now. You can be at peace. We've won the war because L came in as Emmanuel, and he won it for us. All you got to do is admit who you are and what you did. Guilty as charged, deserving of hell. Amen. Forgive me. I'm so sorry. And here's the way. And then once you confess it, you'll get born again into the truth. And the truth is contrary to the world. And that's the rock I've been on since the night I got started. I'm sorry, I can't help it. It's like, I feel like I'm on laughing gas. All right. So, anyway, yeah, there you go. There's the scriptures. What do you think about the hide-and-go-seek thing? Ollie, ollie, oxen free. We've been yoked together with a scorpion. It's like, yeah, it's true. It's all true. That's why when I started waking up, I was like, what the hell is going on? My family's turning against me. I mean, it was okay when I was like gangsta, guns, Tech Nines in the car and cars blowing up and, you know, cops and, you know, jails and whatever. Oh, that's all good. It's all okay. But as soon as I started coming to faith, you know, all this weird stuff was all over me. I'm like, what is going on? And then as soon as I started talking about God and Jesus, it was like, well, just look at your neighborhood watch signs. But it's from those closest to you. Your worst enemies will be members of your own household. Of course they are, because it's a scorpion race. And unless you get converted, you're still accessible from the one from the pit. You want me to prove it? Watch this. I love the scriptures. The word of God is perfect. Watch this. So you know what? I'll just do it real quick right here. So we'll just open up Bible Gateway. Watch this. So see, people that aren't set free, they're just part of the host body system. And you know, I showed you what the Lord of Hosts means, right? Okay, so let's see. 2 Timothy 2. Okay, here we go. End of the chapter. Here we go. Watch this. Okay, and meekness instructing those that oppose themselves. Okay, I'm going to take the screen for a second. There is a right side up and an upside down you, a double you. You oppose yourself. There's a good you and a bad you. You're at odds with yourself. You're yoked together with a demon you. I mean, it's all there is to it. It's so obvious. And that's what runs this system. So look, in meekness, instructing those that oppose themselves. If God peradventure will give them repentance, look, to the acknowledging of the truth, that they may recover themselves out of the snare, which is a trap that turns you upside down, of the devil, who are taken captive by him at his will. Told you. So, see, it's just like the Matrix movie. Agent Smith could access anybody at any time. That's why we don't wrestle against flesh and blood. The flesh and blood is just a system. It's a host body system for the battle to play out. And that's why, you know, we're supposed to pray for our enemies. Because if someone's being an idiot and they're being hateful, mean, cruel, or whatever, it just means that they're taken by the one in the pit. Yeah. All glory to God. I want to give all the glory to God. Emmanuel. Get it out there, folks. Let's end it on the I'm sorry, I got one more picture. I can't believe I almost forgot. This is it. Check it out. Check this out. Okay, so you've seen this, but you haven't seen the last picture. Okay, say it yourself. Danielle. Danielle. Mikael. Yoel. Samuel. Emmanuel. Okay? L is the Almighty God. Now watch this. So here we go. Here we go. Watch this. Let's see. Right here. And now remember, I told you everything's a mirror image, right side up, upside down, the whole system. And that's what Jesus was showing us through the scriptures in many different places, like Isaiah 29, 15, and 16. Woe unto them who go to great depths to hide their plans from the Lord. Their works are in the darkness, and they say, who seeth us, who knoweth us? Surely your turning of things upside down shall be esteemed as a potter's clay. Well, we're already upside down, so if you flip it, you're really turning things right side up. So you can see the kingdom of God, just like the Bible says. You see it, and then you're like, oh my gosh. So look at this. Matthew 27. Now from the sixth hour, see the six? There was darkness over all the land. Six represents the flesh. Until the ninth hour, which represents judgment. And in the ninth hour, Jesus cried with a loud voice. Look, Eli, Eli. It's really Ali, Ali, income free. Everybody gets to come in free. Ali, Ali, lama sabachthani, to say, my God, why hast thou forsaken me? Look, Ali, 2241, Ali, 2241, Ali, right here, of Hebrew origin, Hebrew word, 410. My God, El, the Almighty God. So this is all in your show notes. And no one can argue with the truth. All glory to God. I hope this pumped you up. I'm so pumped up. I'm sorry that I can't help but just laugh through this. But, you know, there they are. Oh, who rules the world? No, Michelle. Sack swinger, sweetie, no. No, no, no. You and your hermaphrodite buddies, and I I'm sorry that if that's the deal, but, you know, the whole trying to change the whole sex thing, no. Doesn't get you off the hook. Nope. So, God have mercy on them. I want to pray for every one of them. I want to pray for Alicia Keys, Michael Obama, Lady Gaga. God have mercy on them. I do. I really feel sorry for them. I do. You know, I bet they're probably fun to hang out with. You know, I'm just a real person. I've been around. I've hung out with people you would not believe, some of the people I've hung out with. And they were really nice people. You know, they have a part of them that's good. They're like all of us. There's a good you and there's a bad you. And, you know, we're supposed to try and access the good you. And we are ministers of reconciliation. We are here to reconcile the world back to Christ. We're here to get you to come home. We want you to come home. Just quit, let go of your pre-indoctrination. Look at what the Lord's shown this crazy guy, Kleck. It's not arguable. All right. I love you guys. Y'all are my joy, just to know that I got to share this with everybody. And by the way, I love you. Thank you for your comments, your kind comments. And thank you for, you know, encouraging me. Because I'll be honest, there's days where it's like, oh, I can't go another step. Just kill me. It's like just get it over with. That's just so, Anyway, okay, I love you guys so much. I'm so grateful. I'm so grateful that God gave me such a meaningful life that I could help others. That's where true meaning comes from. Because love, the number one thing about love is it suffers long. I'm like, yeah, I got that going for me. Oh, yeah, man, I'm going to get my ass kicked for 17 years. Anyway, I believe that ass kicking is coming to an end. So I hope y'all are like pumped up, cheered up. Now we're going to do the folder on the next video, and I'm just going to go through all the data. Now that you've seen this video, now let's go use all their data against them. And it's going to be like, oh, you're going to freak out. It's going to be an overload. I love y'all so much. Thank you so much. Thank you for letting me serve you. Amen. Praise God.